Hello there my friends, it's your boy Ivan here and we are looking at another compilation of bad winter drivers. Now, driving in winter is not that difficult. There are mainly two factors that contribute to these accidents. First one is obviously speed, like this one enters a corner like it's summer and it's warm outside and it's not raining. And the other one is bad winter tires. Now, I mean, this one, for example, yanked the steering wheel like he was milking a cow. Now, by those two factors, first speed and the other one, bad winter tires or lack of winter tires, you can judge, if you want, the speed, the braking distance and all sorts of other stuff that can make you crash. I mean, let's be honest here, if you are, I mean, it's nothing but about the tires at some point. I mean, if you are in a hurry to get somewhere and you know there is winter, come on, do not expect to get in the same time to that destination you would in the summer. Okay. What was he? You see, I bet he had summer tires. Now this one, I mean, come on, he's traveling 130 kilometers an hour easy. Look at that impact. He did about 720 degrees turns there. Now, even in this one, that was a bit, if he used his brain a little bit and, oh my god, man, these are so 40 kilometers an hour there, and at least he did not destroy his car completely, and he did not destroy other people's cars completely, like this guy. He even tried to overtake near a corner. Imagine that in those road conditions. This looks like there is even ice on the road. Well, at least he, only his car got wrecked. Okay, effort focus here, but he braked. He wasn't traveling really that fast in order to lose complete control. What happened even here? I mean, let's be honest here, cars do not slide at a low speed or standing still. Speed is always involved, a higher than recommended speed. This one again related to speed. They were trying to avoid the other one coming the other way. That was funny a bit. Luckily they did not get hurt. Now, I mean, this is not even related. He was a moron before we reached the snow part. He deserved that and he did not hit any other cars. 360. Not into the ditch. Nicely done. I'll give it a 7 out of 5. Okay, somebody's overtaking. He again appeared that he yanked the steering wheel like he was, you know, playing with his pee-pee maybe. You need to be gentle in the winter when you're turning. Gentle on the brakes, gentle with the steering wheel, and gentle with the throttle, obviously. Another 720 into the barrier. Nice. And facing the other way around. Man, that was intense right there. And there you go. Man, those snow banks are not even that bad actually. It didn't pop the airbags, nothing. As good as new. Now, let's be honest, he was going fast, but that truck also. And this is just a pile-up, you don't even know what to do here. These are the scariest type of accident, I guess. You just stand in your car after you crash and a 20-ton semi-truck comes, who knows, at 100 kilometers an hour because he's an idiot and he decides to speed. in those road conditions and you just shish kebab. Hold it. Hold it. Yeah, he hold it. Of course, way too fast into a corner. He started Tokyo drifting. 1, 2, 3. And he hold it. Noise. Noise. Cool, 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 cool. Noise. This is prime time road education for you, my friends. Again, speed into a corner. What can go wrong? 360 facing, nice, nice. You just can continue. Ooh, this is a beautiful. I like when roads are like this with this freshly, fresh snow. Okay, yep. And this is an interesting stop light there, traffic light. Okie doke. Okay, turning, nice. Is he accelerating? Yeah, I think he did that kind of on purpose, maybe, who knows, but he got what he deserved. Oh, it's so beautiful snowing there. No, not a beautiful no. And the boot opened. Maybe, who knows, that's a good thing, maybe the boot got stuck. And now this is not even a road, where is even the road here? This video is from China. It's, I don't know if it makes any sense, but it was from China. Okay, overtaking into the ditch straight. Not that bad. Okay, 180 so far. And back the other way around. Not into the fence. Nice, nice. Now you see how heavy these trucks are. He pushed that pickup truck there like there was nothing. Okay, who should shut their pants here? Yes, is the car. Of course, taking out the other car. Nice. And I think the guy in the car that was hit shut their pants. Because it was unexpected, but who knows? Skid mark underwear is never a good thing. Alright. To the fence, of course, now that beautiful fence of people. Come on, man, you're with a Subaru Impreza, that's not how you're supposed to drive. And into the ditch. Luckily the houses are far away from the road. No, Lada Niva overtaking very graciously so far. And there it goes, 1, 2. Nice, nice, very nicely stopped there. You would be able to drive out of there like nothing happened. Okay. Oh, and he flipped it. Nah, that's not good. But still, could be worse. A lot of these accidents could be a lot worse if another car was hit head-on. And a lot of them are on highways. I mean, come on, I know you're on a highway, but why travel at the same speed as on a clean surface? Again, highway. And don't tell me they are not driving at, I don't know, 100 kilometers an hour maybe. Randomly Tokyo drifting in front, that Ford Focus estate. And Yeah, I think he hold it. My friends, check my gaming channel, link is in the description below as always. Hope you enjoyed this video, hope you learned some lessons, another beautifully executed pirouette there. And yeah, see in future videos. And of course he hit the park car.